two chisels, Phillips screwdriver, Allen wrenches. Now take a look to your right, you'll see the USS Midway there. Now the Midway is an amazing museum to get, like if you guys get a chance. What's amazing about the Midway is as you go through the ship, you'll meet people that served on the ship when it was active. And so it's like a living museum. We went through there and this guy was talking about the evacuation of Hanoi. And he was talking about how they were pushing helicopters off the edge of the ship so other helicopters could land. It was just amazing. The Midway was nationally recognized by the White House. You're standing in the middle of the street. Not a good idea. The Midway, this is the restaurant at the fantail of the ship. And these are our memorials. We have the aircraft carrier memorial, a replica of the homecoming memorial. And to the right of the fish market, you'll see the statue with the two people kissing. That's unconditional surrender. The kids celebrating the end of World War II. Now in the water to your right, this is the remnants of San Diego's tuna fleet. It fell on hard times in the 1970s due to heavy regulation and fish migration. I guess you might say it floundered. So we canned it. I did that on purpose. Just for the halibut? Okay, I'm vintage. Didn't want to give you a headache. Didn't want to make you ill. I guess I'll scale back. Hey, I heard a pretty good pirate once. Do you guys know why pirates can't do the alphabet? Because they always get lost at sea. Do you know what the pirate's favorite letter of the alphabet is?
R.
No, it's P. It's like an R with one leg. Did the Godzilla dance after that one. Now, if you like pirates, there's a store here just for you called the Captain's Cove. There's a store for cool and funny hats. They might even have cheese heads for some of the people from Wisconsin back there. It's called the Village Hat Shop. There's a store for kites. There's a store for mugs. There's a store for nostalgia. Lots of cool places here in Seaport Village. Is anybody still looking for breakfast? No? Okay. Because the next stop is right by Richard Walker's Pancake House. The most amazing apple cinnamon pancake in the world ever. Some more Wisconsinites enjoying the West Coast. Hello, Wisconsin! We should make that a thing where I, like, call down and the whole trailer goes, hello, Wisconsin! I like that 70s show. That was a good show. Okay. Here, Jim. I had a big crush on Donna. She was so hot. Now, look. See the circular building there? That's the carousel. They have a food court over there for you. Here at Seaport Village, they also have two Ben & Jerry's ice cream. One of my favorites in the morning. This little place here, Upstart Crow, a little bookstore coffee shop. So you can get your latte and check out the New York Times bestsellers. So what do you guys think? Is this a beautiful day or what? How many of you were walking around in the humidity yesterday? Yeah, me too. Wow. Oh, really? You had a graduation there? That's an amazing thing to witness. Oh, with pigeons attack. Oh my goodness. A piece of action. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you're stepping down here at Seaport, these trolleys try to be here approximately 20 after and 10 till the hour, okay?
And ladies and gentlemen, this would be our stop for Seaport Village. 59 specialty shops, 6 sit-down restaurants, and 11 eateries. Have a great day. Wow, was it something I said? Was it all the punishment? Hey, have a great... Charlie's are here at 20 after and 10 till the hour. Have a great day now, guys. Have a good day. And welcome. Welcome. Hi, where are you guys from? Austria. Good to have you with us. Well, this was the ghost trolley, and it was the only one at the barn. We're not using ghost sound effects. Actually, we are. Actually, our friends that just joined us from Austria, you brought up a really painful memory.
I'm back.
No!
I have some advice for all you travelers out there on the tour.
Yeah,
you had better stay seated while we're in motion. Keep your body parts inside at all times. Watch out for those low-hanging branches. They're not friendly. No smoking or alcoholic beverages, or you might be terminated. We want you back.
I know someone who doesn't want you back there, Arnold. I don't think Austria wants you back either. Welcome to everyone that just joined us. My name's Larry. So good to have you with us here today. Making our way out of Seaport Village. And, well, we've had a lot of movies filmed here in San Diego. Here to our left, this is the old police department building. This is where they filmed that great B-movie, Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. This was San Diego's police department for 1938 to 1985. They said you were taken there, you were photographed, processed, fingerprinted, jailed, and had your court appearance all in one place. A lot of folks called it a one-stop cop shop. Well, going on that theme, you see that building with the jagged glass windows? Those are million-dollar condominiums. Now, the beige building to the left of it with the vertical windows, that's a federal penitentiary. So the joke is, if you make $1 million, you can stay in one. If you steal $1 million, you can stay in the other. That's Club Med and Club Fed. Now, over your shoulder, you see the red awnings and the blue umbrellas? That's the Kansas City barbecue. That's where they filmed the bar scene for the movie Top Gun. That's where Tom Cruise and his friend Goose played Great Balls of Fire on the piano.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill.
Goodness gracious, Great Balls of Fire. You might even remember when Jurassic Park had one of their tyrannosaurs running through our downtown in that movie, The Lost World. Making our way, folks, take a look to your left at San Diego's largest brick building. You know, concerning the buildings here in San Diego, they give out two architecture awards. They have the Morgan Award for beautiful buildings and the Onion Award for buildings that aren't so appealing. That's an Morgan Award winner. And then you see this building with the solar panels. Little puppy. What a ferocious co-pilot. There's a picture. And then there's the guy talking on the subway. All right, making our way to our top. Now these buildings along the waterfront, top of the Hyatts there, those are the chisels of that downtown toolbox. The top of it, the rigging is supposed to look like the rigging of a sailboat. The Marriott here looks like the bows of two ships converging. And, the convention center, a lot of people believe it looks like the architect's idea was pretty much a yacht moving through the ocean. Those rolling glass trenches, kind of like waves coming.
down here.
Okay.
We'll make our way to Horton Plaza. 11 and a half acres of shopping joy. Every time I see one of those little dogs, it reminds me of that movie in Fish Called Wanda. You want to come for me?
I'm home.
All right. Oh, look at the vintage streetcar up ahead of us there. Ride of glass. Beautiful. If you guys like trains just like I do, if you go up to Balboa Park, we have the largest operational model railroad museum in the nation. It's so great. You're going to hear about John Spreckles, the Sugar King. He actually built the railway connecting San Diego to Arizona. Has the largest wooden railway trestle in the nation. And you can see replicas of that in N-scale and HO at that model railroad museum. My only complaint is, if somebody's walking behind a mountain, they should be wearing a Godzilla outfit. But it's a cool place. It's fun. Now, ahead of us, this is the Martin Luther King Promenade. This linear walk along Harbor Drive has quotes of Dr. King there in the pavement. San Diego, we love our blue sky, we love our beaches, but we're not going to miss out on winter fun. This is our outdoor ice skating rink for the holiday season. They even want to create one on the beach in front of the Hotel Del Coronado, believe it or not. The elevator up into the shopping mall is to the right of the pharmacy there. Ladies and gentlemen, this would be our first stop for downtown San Diego, Horton Plaza, and the northern end of the Gaslamp Quarter. Thank you for joining us today. They're here at the top and the bottom of the hour.
You guys have a great day out there. Hi. Where are you visiting from, sir?
Yeah, from Mexico City.
Well, buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
Oh, it's 12:01. Buenos tardes. How you doing today, Pete? Okay. Well, I'm a double thumper. Gotta reach that inside wheel. She's out here for a reason, I don't know. No. So we're all good, I guess. I don't see any fashion accessories running this way. Well, okay, great. You know this one seats 38, right? Takes a village. Where are you from again? We'll call them and see if someone's missing. All right, we're going to be making our way. So, do you guys want to do that Hello Wisconsin thing or what? Like, if we see like a pack of people wearing green through this, I'll just count down and I'll go, okay, here we go. Hello, Wisconsin. We'll go 3, 2, 1. And then we'll just all exuberantly shout like pirates, hello, Wisconsin. You guys want to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, so because I think we're going to be going into the gas lamp. There's going to be lots of football, college ball going on. So we might come across random groups of folks. Okay, so that in mind. In the meantime, just a reminder, no standing while we're moving, no smoking, and please keep your arms inside. Now, we have the U.S. Grant Hotel. This was built by Ulysses S. Grant Jr. in honor of his father, the President of the United States. It was purchased by the Kumeyaay Indians. Take a look to your left inside the glass doors to see the beautiful chandeliers in the lobby. This is where Horton originally had his hotel. You'll notice how the street's 5 lanes wide here. That's because Horton wanted to see the water all the way from his hotel. So he made Broadway 5 lanes wide all the way behind us through the waterfront. Something to keep in mind when you design your city. Now you see this palace, Pawnbrokers? This was one of Wyatt Earp's gambling houses. Wyatt Earp had 3 gambling houses and 4 oyster bars. Now, in the 1890s, the new town went bust, and this area fell to disrepair and disrepute. It became known as the Stingaree District. They say that behind the Stingaree, there were 70 gambling houses, 60 saloons, and 120, shall we say, gentlemen's clubs. So the area didn't fare much better through the decades. Actually, this shopping center was the main thing that started the redevelopment of the downtown. Horton Plaza cost $140 million. Within its first year, it brought over $300 million of investment into the downtown area. What's so cool about this gas lamp is you can see shades of San Diego's past in the modern-day gas lamp. There are brass plaques in the older buildings showing you the older San Diego. See that yellow building across the street to our left? That was the original carriage works. And then the 4-story building next to it was the police department, the public library, and the original city hall. Making our way to our stop for the lower gas lamp quarter. Yeah, it could be. Occupy San Diego could be. And ladies and gentlemen, this would be our stop for the lower gas lamp corner.
Hey, have a good day, guys. Nice to see you. Be well, Australia. You guys have a nice day. Take care, New York. Nice to see you today. And welcome. Good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
Good.
Where are you from?
Wisconsin.
Oh, good to have you with us. 3, 2, 1. Hey, Wisconsin! So good to have you with us here today. Now,
don't look over there. I hurt your eyes.
Well, no, I want to tell you guys about this building over here, because this is actually a really cool story. You see, these buildings both used to be where the shopping center is today, and they both date back to the 1880s when Wyatt Earp was in town. He stayed here at the Horton Grand. Now, there was a big public outcry when they were talking about tearing them down. So San Diego had a heroic contractor who stepped in, bought both of these hotels for $1 each, meticulously took them apart, and recreated them here. You'll see the dark lines in the walls where they were put back together. In fact, there's even a ghost that moved with the hotel. Ghost of a gambler by the name of Roger Whittaker, who's in room 309. The guests that stay in that room claim that they'll go to sleep with the chain scattered on the nightstand. They'll wake up the following morning. Hi. Welcome, welcome. To wake up the following morning to find their change neatly stacked and sorted like poker chips. Roger Whittaker, the ghost of the Horton Grand. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be leaving San Diego's Gas Lamp Quarter. We're going to be leaving the physical manifestation of free speech. We're going to be leaving the shopping and restaurants. We're going to be making our way to our stop for the Hilton and then out to beautiful Coronado. How's everybody doing this morning? Good to have you with us. Like that Cost Plus World Market there. Candy and trinkets from all over the world. This Gas Lamp Quarter really comes alive in the evening. Live music, everything from blues to rock and roll, disco, salsa, and merengue. See the old spaghetti factory up ahead of us? One of my favorite cheap dates downtown. That's the Decini building. It was the first to be restored by the Center City Development Corp. It set the standard for the restoration. See the convention center? A lot of folks use those steps there as part of their workout program. Every year happens every July, the International Comic Convention.
Yes.
Comic-Con brought over 140,000 people to San Diego this year. In fact, here at Fifth and Harbor, we have groups of Klingons walking around. There was a little R2-D2 with a little drink train going across Harbor Drive here. Wonder Woman was here, looking good. I don't know where she parked her invisible jet. Comic-Con, always a fun week. Yeah. Coming up to your left, you'll see the latest catalyst for the downtown area, the Padres' new baseball stadium, Petco Park. They say since the baseball stadium is open, it's about $1.7 billion of investment into the downtown area. Well, let's hear it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, It's like LSU and Alabama or something. Big game, I think. Right? 5 o'clock?
Wow.
See, I went to San Diego State. We didn't really have a football team, so. Anybody stepping down here? All right. Hi, guys. Let me take a quick look to see how many seats we got here. Deal with my umbilical cord here. Hi, let me just take a quick look for you. Okay. So I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16.
Yep, you're good.
I think we got everybody. The bad news is, let me see if I have any fashion accessories here. There we go. Okay, well, you guys have your tickets already. You'll be fine. But you step down in Coronado, make sure you get one of these great fashion accessories. They'll take care of that in either Coronado or Old Town for you, okay? Where are you guys from? Well, welcome to the West Coast. Good to have you with us. Welcome. They'll take care of those tickets in either Coronado or Old Town, okay? Welcome, welcome. Hi there. They'll take care of those tickets. Welcome, Wisconsin. Good to have you out here.
Go Pats.
Go Chargers. Hi there. Where are you visiting, young sir? Baltimore. Well, welcome to the West Coast. Boy, no defense wants to go against your offense. Your team's like a bunch of orcs. You're just like, we want your second line, too. Well, welcome to everyone that just joined us. Everyone that just joined us, I know you came on board with like slips of paper. Do you know how this tour works?
No.
Okay, let me just take a moment and tell you. This is a 2-hour narrated tour of San Diego and Coronado. The cool thing about this tour is that there are 11 stops, and that these trolleys are at each one of those stops every half hour. So you can step down, you can do some shopping, you can grab a bite to eat, and then you can catch another trolley and continue on your way. Now, there are two other important things that you need to know. When we go to Coronado, you're going to get a yellow sheet of paper that has the last three boarding times. Those are pretty much in the 3 o'clock hour. So it's like, if you would decide to step down and go see that hotel at Coronado, the important time to be back on the trolley is by 4:05. If you're going to Balboa Park or the San Diego Zoo today, the important time to be back on the trolley is 3:25. Now, this is also the important point of disclosure. The reason I'm going through all this is I want to make sure that we're all on the same page. I don't want anybody to get mad later on and whatever, but this is what happens. You see, in the afternoon, a lot of people decide that they want to move around. And most of these trolleys only seat 35 people. I'm the guy driving the biggest one today. This one seats 38. In an emergency, it can seat 40. In the event we don't have a seat for everyone, we'll call our dispatcher. He'll let us know how many seats are following or approximately how long you can expect to wait. I'm just going to tell you, on the weekend, sometimes it is not uncommon to wait over half an hour to reboard a trolley. Are we all good? Okay. Once again, my name's Larry. I'm so glad to have you with us here today. You guys ready to go back to having fun?
Yes.
Okay. So we're going to be making our way over the Coronado Bridge. My friends that have their windows rolled down, it's a good thing. We're going to have lots of fresh air, but you might also get ready for your complimentary hairstyle. It's going to get a little windy. But I'm a professional and I'm proud of my work. Those of you that just joined us, just a reminder of our safety guidelines. Please no standing while we're moving, no smoking, and please keep your arms inside. All right. So I know we've added people and lost people since Old Town. How many of you, this is your first time out to San Diego? a lot of people. Well, so good to have you with us. After that rain yesterday and the beautiful blue sky today, in just about 6 minutes, we are going to have a fantastic view from the Coronado Bay Ridge. Oh, nothing like the smell of sulfur in the morning, really. Now, take a look to your right, you'll see the containers. Bananas are one of the major imports to San Diego. We are the banana gateway of the West from South America. We get over 127 million boxes of bananas through San Diego every year. 29 million boxes of pineapple. That's a lot of fruit. One thing you guys got to try while you're out here, you got to get a good carne asada burrito. Marinated grilled chopped steak that's put into a flour tortilla with guacamole, tomatoes, and cilantro. They're about $4, $4 to $5 in a pretty much meal. Carne asada burrito. One of the great Mexican food there for you in Old Town. Or stop there, that second stop in Coronado. By the freeway and the bridge about 50 years ago, and this caused a big public outcry. But underneath it today, a beautiful manifestation of artistic expression, Chicano Park, 80 murals celebrating Mexican American culture and heritage. Chicano Park. I can play some handball here today. Governor Ronald Reagan. The bridge is 2.3 Well, take a look to your right. You'll see that catamaran-like vehicle tied up to the pier with the gray camouflage. That's the sea flag. That's used by the United States Navy for assault across sea conditions. Had 16 lights. Okay, you go up to the light, go left, and it's 27 blocks down. Or you stay here, and there's a bus that will take you. Okay. Take a left, and that's Orange Avenue. That's the main street. Yeah. Okay. And welcome to everyone that just joined us. My name's Larry. How are you guys doing?
Wonderful.
Welcome, welcome. Good to have you with us. Great to see your colors walking around. Welcome, Wisconsin. My name's Larry. Nice to have you with us here today. Just a reminder, no standing while we're moving. Hi, did you have a question? Nope? Okay, just checking.
Cheryl Roberts.
All right, we're going to be making our way to our stop closer to the historic hotel and the beach. My name's Larry. Just a reminder, no standing while we're moving. No smoking. That downtown toolbox, you'll see those hands look like chisels. There's a building that looks like a Phillips screwdriver. In between the two chisels, a set of Allen wrenches. That's our downtown toolbox. Now you look at all this beautiful real estate today. It's hard to believe that all this got started with a couple of rabbit hunters in 1884. San Diego had two prominent was Elijah Babcock, who was a railroad financier from Evansville, Indiana. The second guy was Hampton Storing of the Storing Clark Piano Fortune, based in Chicago. Now, a popular thing to do here during the 1880s was to come out here and hunt jackrabbits. This was Elmer Fudd's paradise. There were 10,000 jackrabbits. Babcock and Story came out here one day in 1884 to do some rabbit hunting. They took a rest on the sandy ride, and then they noticed this, that's where Elijah Babcock had the idea of creating a luxury seaside resort. Now, it took him a couple months to talk his friend Story into signing on with him, but eventually he did. They got together $60,000, put it in the First National Bank of San Diego, took out a loan for $110,000, and they bought all the land here. Now, they had secured the land for their hotel. Now, it was more a matter of raising the capital to build it. So, to do this, they took out newspaper ads in all the major cities across the nation, advertising the grandeur of the land and the glory of the climate here in Coronado. Now, they say timing is everything. The following year, at this point, was 1887. And this is when the railroad first started coming out to San Diego. Initially, those railroad tickets were kind of pricey. It cost you $100 to get out to San Diego. But with the rush for land and the boom that was happening in the city, there was a railroad rate war that soon followed. And the ticket prices dropped. They fell from $100 down to $50. From $50 down to $25. And at the height of the railroad rate war, you could get all the way out to San Diego for the price of $1, and they give you 50 cents back after you put your feet on the ground. So as you can imagine, the railroad rates and the newspaper ads were pretty key. Babcock and Story managed to get 6,600 people out here to Coronado to take part in their land auction. And their lots fetch prices ranging from $100 over $2,300. That's pretty good, especially when you take into account they had bought those lots a year and a half earlier for just $7 a piece. Made a lot of money to create their hotel. That's when they got the Reed brothers out here to help them. Now they had secured the land, they had raised the capital, and they got the architects. Now it was about getting the building materials because San Diego pretty much a desert by the ocean. So they got a hold of some folks up in San Francisco. And the idea was to get some of the beautiful redwood, also Northern California. So there wasn't really a railway to bring the wood here. So the idea was to place the wood into large bundles. The pluggies. Place the wood in large bundles and use the natural currents of the Pacific Ocean to float the wood down the coast of California. The bundles were brought into San Diego Bay. That street where we were just on was a railway that brought the wood up to the hotel and the tent city. An idea they had to make it even more special for the guests was to plant citrus trees on either side of the track. So as the guests made their way up to the hotel, sipping their champagne, they could reach out and pluck a nice fresh piece of fruit. Well, they planted those trees and the locals loved the idea, but 1 year later, there were no trees left. That's because the locals at the time were the jackrabbits, and they loved the tender bark in the base of the trees. So the only remnants of that great idea is the name of the main street there, Orange Avenue. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you think of this view today?
Gorgeous.
Do you see the Cabrillo Lighthouse at the top of Point Loma? The grouping of buildings in the middle, that's where the Spanish explorer Juan Cabrillo first landed there in 1542. Look, it's so clear today. You can even see Hawaii. Just kidding. Those are the Coronado Islands. When I was a kid, we called them Dead Man's Islands because they look like a guy lying down in the water. And this time of year, this is what the sport fishing's doing. Some pretty good things. Been hooking up with some yellowtail, some bluefin tuna, and a lot of. Here to your right. Well, one of the amazing things about the Hotel del Coronado is the fact that it was originally constructed without formal blueprints. Essentially, they'd break out scratch paper at the end of the night and say, well, you want to go long or you want to try something? That's why the hotel is such an interesting place to look at. Filmed the movie here in 1958, starring Tony Curtis, Jack Lemmon, and Marilyn Monroe. The Hotel Del started as a seaside resort in Florida, and the movie was Something Like It Hot. Just to give you the lay of the land, it's a 2-block walk back to the hotel, about a 3-block walk to the beach. There are 70 restaurants to choose from along Orange Avenue. And ladies and gentlemen, our trolley's trying to be here at 5 and 35 minutes after the hour. Once again, I'm Larry. Thanks for joining us. Have a great day. Thank you so much, sir. Sincerely appreciate that. Have a nice day. Watch your step. You guys enjoy that game tomorrow.
Go pack.
Have a good day now. Thank you so much, sir. Sincerely appreciate that. Watch your step. Oh, Mark, I hope you have plenty of stickers. A lot of these people don't have stickers or time schedules. Mark is the man to help you if you need stickers or time schedules. That could be, have a great day. Enjoy Wisconsin and Denver. Have a good day, guys. Thank you very much. Watch your step. No hurries, no worries. You got it there, Mama. Watch that first step here. It's a little farther down. Yeah, it is a long one. And those handrails are there to help you. How the rest of you doing? Doing good?
Yeah.
Where are you guys from?
Canada.
Canada, what part?
Well, Ontario.
Oh, Ontario. Well, good to have you today. We got
plenty of.
All aboard! 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Looks like I've got about 20 minutes. I'm good. How are you, man?
All right.
Well, where do we go next?
4 days off. Oh, and then vacation? So are you going to mainland Mexico? Is that where you're going? Are you planning a trip in the spring? I have to talk to you because, you know, I have my godfather's Shazam mobile, right?
Oh, yeah.
That 1974, and it's ready to go.
All right. Well,
so let's go to La Paz and take a ferry across. We got everybody.
I'll call you.
That's why Larry's rolling with the big buggy today. This is the biggest trolley we have. And it's got the best view of all of them. What more could you ask for? Welcome to everyone that just joined us from Coronado. How are you guys doing today?
Great.
Good. Now, okay, I'm going to take a little poll. How many people on this trolley have not seen Balboa Park yet? Oh, wow. You're going to love this place. This is like Europe happened in Southern California. This place is just beautiful. Let me just arrange this so money doesn't fly away. We don't like money flying away. Life's too expensive. That. Yeah. All right. Well, as we get underway, Humphrey Bogart stopped by with something to say. Here's some words from him.
Hello, sweetheart. Of all the tours in all the world, you had to walk into mine. Well, I just want to clue you in on some dangerous situations. Now, lay low and stay in your seat. And keep your mitts and mugs inside, see? Smoking is bad news, and so are dames and drinking, so don't mess with them. You may not believe me now or tomorrow, but someday and for the rest of your life, you'll know that I'm right.
Making our way out of beautiful Coronado. Coronado here. One of 10 small towns across the nation to have won that Main Street USA award. Used it for the creation of the military here, the Center Divide, and the police department building. Spreckles built that railway connecting San Diego out to Arizona. And he also, you can see replicas of that railway in N-scale and HO at that Natural History Museum there in Balboa Park. I'm sorry, the Model Railroad Museum. Natural History Museum has a sea monster for you. Maybe I'll tell you that story in a little bit. Okay, I'm looking for you. Where are you going to, buddy? Looks like away from us, so good. How's everyone doing? What do you think about this Old Town Trolley Tour? Good way to get around, or what? Look at it this way, on the weekend, you don't have to deal with parking all day long.
Thank you.
Now, Coronado here was the birthplace of naval aviation. This last February, we had 200 vintage aircraft fly right over San Diego Bay. And it all started here 100 years ago with a man by the name of Curtis. He had one aircraft that had been built by the Wright brothers, two airplanes that he had built himself. Other firsts in naval aviation, the first amphibious landing by T.T. Ellison. Tiny Broderick, she was the first person to do a free fall ripcord pulling parachute jump. She did that jump six times in one day. You felt terrible. The first carrier was the Langley. Runway at the top of it. North Island Naval Air Station today is home port to the USS Vinson, the largest and fastest of the aircraft carriers, the USS Ronald Reagan. The United States Navy is one of the largest contributors to San Diego's economy. Contributes $17 billion annually. Thank you. Breast cancer awareness. San Diego's a lot of organizations, businesses, and people were raising money this entire month. It's a beautiful thing. See that Fort Bay fig tree? A lot of people believe that was planted by the mother of the park. That's a statue in honor of her, Kate Sessions. She planted over 4,000 trees. Diego, 1,200 of them here in the city park. This Cabrillo Bridge was the original entrance way to the park for the Panama California Exposition. Look here to your right, the happiest place on earth. That's a park just for the dogs.
Oh yeah,
the exposition that was hosted here brought a lot of art, culture, and animals to San Diego that had never been. On the hillside here to your left. San Diego Zoo today has over 4,400 animals, representing 850 different species. The botanical collection is said to be even more rare, 16,000 different types of plants and trees at San Diego Zoo. Here we go. To your left, you'll see the California Tower. Sculpture there was done by the Piccarilli brothers who worked on the Lincoln Memorial. Got the Old Globe Theater to our left. Sculpture Garden. To our right, the Alcazar Garden. That's the House of Charm. Boy, 12 hours ago I was walking around here extremely wet. Boy, he's coming down last night. Here to our left, the Museum of Art, Botanical Garden. The Visitor Center, great place for you to plan your attack and attack your plan. Up that walkway, Museum of Photographic Arts, Model Railroad Museum, Reuben H. Fleet Science Center, and the Natural History Museum. Ladies and gentlemen, just a reminder, this is also the stop for the San Diego Zoo. Your last pickup here today, 325, 15 museums, 11 gardens. Please watch your step. Hasta la vista, Mexico City. Take care. Have a good one, sir. Wow, was it something I said? Mass exodus here in the park at the Prado. Have a great day, guys. Thanks for joining us. Thank you so much, sir. Have a good day. Have a good day, guys. Nice to see you today. Thank you very much. Hi there. And I can tell by your distinctive badges you are a part of our city tour. Oh, I did such a good job. You came back and did it again. Well, good to see you again. Little Italy. Great restaurants there. They have that place called Extraordinary Desserts. Hi, how are you today? Where are you visiting from? England, checking up on the colonies, are ya? Hi. I see your blue tickets. We'll get you those fashion accessories when you get to Old Town. Hello, how are you guys doing today? Yes, I'll have you there in 20 minutes, sir. 25 minutes. Hi there. And where are you from? Ottawa, Canada. Well, welcome. It was so cool. There was lots of hockey on the... Okay, my friend in the hat, you're part of the city tour, right? Okay, see? That's why we gave you those fashion accessories. A lot of people confuse me with that rent-free park tram, even though it's painted red and I'm orange. So I just had to ask. How's everybody doing? The folks that just joined us in the park, did you guys have a beautiful morning in the park or what? Is this place amazing or what? It's like you walk around and you're like, wow, Southern California. Okay. Anyway, so good to have you guys with us here today. I'm gonna call Mr. Dispatcher Man and we'll be on our way to Little Italy. Making our way to our stop for Little Italy and then Old Town, San Diego. My name's Larry, and welcome to everyone that just joined us. Now take a look to your left. You see that building at the head of the plaza there? That's a large musical instrument. If you come here tomorrow, they have a free concert there at 2 o'clock. That's the Spreckles Organ Pavilion. Given that San Diego by the son of the sugar cane, with the condition we have a free concert, I guess you could say we had a significant organ donor. John Spreckles. The son of the sugar cane. And green light. They didn't know who that guy was or what he was doing. They'd stare out at him, give him some evil looks, and he'd pretty much ignore them. Look at his watch and write notations on a little clipboard. Well, the folks didn't realize it, but that guy was actually Charles Lindbergh. And he was doing two things. Number one, he was practically staying awake long hours because it was a 33-hour flight from New York to Paris. But he was also keeping an eye on the tachometer of the car because he had to switch between the five gas tanks on the Spirit of St. Louis to keep the center of gravity as he made his way across the Atlantic. That's how we would practice running the car behind that hotel, just driving the neighbors batty. Lindbergh used to walk down Laurel Street there to supervise the construction of the Spirit of St. Louis. That's why it's fitting that Laurel Street today ends right there at Lindbergh Field. Making our way back into the downtown area. Downtown has had significant changes. We had over 100 construction sites come up here this last year. To give you an idea of the size and scope of this, there are about just over 30,000 people that live downtown today. By the end of 2012, they anticipate that the population downtown will be somewhere between 50,000 and 80,000 people. Now, of course, the main cast, the thing that started the redevelopment in the mid-80s was that shopping center, Morton Plaza. Within its first year, it brought over $300 million of investment into the downtown area. Latest catalyst would be that baseball stadium, Texas. It's brought $1.7 billion of investment. This last year, they ratified the expansion for the downtown convention center. They broke ground on the new downtown public library. Very soon the voters are going to decide if we get a new city hall to consolidate the city offices. And there's a possibility of a new Chargers football stadium in the downtown area.
I was about to decide.
Making our way into Little Italy, one of the coolest communities downtown here. The Italians first arrived here in the 1880s, but the biggest influx of that population was after the earthquake and fire up there in San Francisco in 1906. That event brought over 6,000 Italian families to relocate to San Diego. The 1930s through the 1970s saw the boom of the commercial fishing industry. San Diego's Little Italy today is 56 blocks. That makes it larger than the Little Italy of St. Louis, San Francisco, and New York combined. One of my favorite restaurants there on Union Street, extraordinary desserts, amazing creme brulee, pumpkin cheesecake this time of year. It's worth it just to go inside to see the amazing desserts they have in their case there. You gotta watch the coffee though. The French press, it will keep you up till 3 o'clock in the morning. They have the bar with the oldest liquor license here. Called the Waterfront. That's one block away on Kettner. Actually, like four blocks away there on Kettner. Mexican Fiesta here, famous for their carne asada burritos. You go there during the week, that little hole in the wall has, they'll have 20 people standing out at that little window. That's the little place right on the other side of the parking lot there. Carne asada burritos. Has a great farmer's market happening here. One block ahead of us there on Dane Street. Hey. Yeah, a little go-kart. cars, they do rent those here in Little Italy, like Laurel and Kettner Street and stuff like that. And ladies and gentlemen, this would be a stuff one. Italian delis, cafes, they have a great farmer's market happening up ahead of
there for a while.
Anyone stepping down? I've got two. Hi, just a second. Got some folks stepping down. Yeah, right here, Cedar Street, sir. And welcome. Hey, yeah, how are you doing today? Great, where are you guys from? Well, Phoenix, welcome out. I gotta get out there and visit you guys. I have an uncle there in Casa Grande.
Oh, yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, not far from you. About 50 miles.
Yeah, I
couldn't go out there 2 months ago. It was too hot. I'm a San Diego weather whip. I'm completely
made it, yeah.
And the other ladies back there, where are you guys from?
Virginia.
Where?
Virginia.
Virginia. First time out to San Diego?
Yes.
Did you guys have a good morning here in Little Italy?
We have.
Did you go walk around the little farmer's market?
Uh-huh.
That's a cool thing, isn't it?
It was.
Good. Well, guys, we're going to make our way up to Old Town San Diego, the only state park where you can get a 30-ounce margarita. Of course, I'm driving today. No margarita for Larry. All right. Well, we're going to find our way to zigzag through this traffic. I don't see any more fashion accessories coming this way, so we're on our way. Don't want that door to make the bike. Making our way out of Little Italy. See, they have banners in honor of the old, well, the families and the significant people in Little Italy's history. Hey, even have an English pub here, the Princess of Wales. Okay, I won't sing Al Green. I'm sorry. The smell of smoked provolone cheese, Kalamata olives, it's everything an Italian market should be. They have a little restaurant here on the right side of it. Here to our left, this guy's pretty amazing. tortillas, like great olive oils and stuff, but he makes his own pasta. So you go in here and there's trays of just all this great pasta that the guy has made. And then if you're here during the week and you want a good sandwich, grab-a-go subs. Now they make an amazing pastrami, but if you're vegetarian, one of my favorites also, melted feta cheese with avocado and olives. Oh my goodness. Grab-a-go subs. Sorry folks, I'm a little fixated on food. I should have had a bigger break here. Now, commercial fishing was one of the prime contributors to this economy. Coming up to your right here on top is you'll see the mural in honor of the Italian fishermen. Well, the Portuguese, Chinese, Japanese, and the Italians were all big in San Diego fishing. They say in the 1950s, San Diego had 13 canneries that were going full tilt. In fact, there was a train that would leave San Diego in the 1950s that was actually 10 miles long. It would leave San Diego once a week. 1,100 boxcars full of bumblebee tuna leaving San Diego once a week. Now, of course, the ocean couldn't sustain that demand, and the commercial fishing industry fell to hard times in the 1970s due to heavy regulation and fish migration. But San Diego today does boast one of the largest sport fishing fleets. Now, I heard some beautiful news concerning this about a month ago. There's an organization that's here in San Diego that has a sister operation in Croatia, and out there they were able to successfully farm bluefin tuna. So they've just started to do that off the coast of Baja here. I think it's a wonderful thing. I mean, they're beautiful, smart, intelligent animals. Their downfall is they are delicious. So anyway, they're going to start successfully farming bluefin tuna. We like this idea. That's Top Hat Hill to our right. In the movie Top Gun, Tom Cruise was on his motorcycle. Kelly McGillis was in her Porsche, and they were racing up that hill to get to the beach. That's where the jokes Hollywood plays on it. How many beaches do you know of that are actually uphill? Not too many. To our left, beautiful view of downtown San Diego.
Executive Officer of Historic Tours of America. Maybe you've heard about us or even taken our tours before. I hope so. One of the best ways for our company to find out how we're doing is to hear from you. I hope you've had a chance to take a look at your ticket. You'll see that it's also a comment card. I'd like to ask you to do a very special favor for me, as well as our guests in the future. Take a minute and fill out this card and tell me what you think about your tour today. It has a place for you to put your address, who sold you the ticket, where you heard about us, and who your conductor is. Feel free to give us your comments about the tour and anything else you wish. Then just drop it in the mailbox and I'll pay the postage. It's very simple, but it's very important to us. It's only when we hear from you, our honored guests, that we are able to improve what we're doing. On behalf of all the cast members of Historic Tours of America, may I say thank you for being with us today, and thanks for your help.
Once again, my name's Larry. Always great to hear from you on those comment cards. Coming up to our right, El Indio, the birthplace of the Taquito. They have their own little tortilleria in the restaurant there. And this is the newest one coming up to our right. It was featured on Man vs. Food, Lucha Libre. See the line of people out there. Had the most insane taco there last week. A bacon wrapped grilled mahi taco. Anyway, I'll stop talking about food and let them talk to you about the website they have that'll help you plan. They are
proud member of Trusted Tours and Attractions. When you're planning your next vacation, log on to trustedtours.com, where you can compare quality tours, buy and rent tickets, and plan your vacation before you start it. Again, the site is www.trustedtours.com.
Well, making our way into the original settlement of San Diego, the Spanish first arrived here in 1542. Spanish explorer Juan Cabril got blown into San Diego Bay by a Pacific storm. He wrote down his coordinates and he named this region San Miguel after the Archangel St. Michael. 60 years after that, another explorer came through here by the name of Juan Sebastian Vizcaino. Cabrillo's coordinates, so he renamed this region after a Franciscan friar by the name of St. Didicus. That's where San Diego gets its name from. Now, Spain didn't do too much with the territory here until Russian fur traders started making their way south along the Pacific coast, collecting otter pelts as they made their way. Well, being that the Russians were coming, this got Spain very nervous. That's when they dispatched the Gaspar de Bartola, who created the first port here in San Diego, and Juan Emperor Serra, who created the first Spanish mission as well. Now, around 1811, Mexico began to rebel against Spanish colonization. In fact, Mexico achieved independence 10 years later, in 1821. That's when the Spanish soldiers moved down the hill and created the settlement that became Diego. Now, Old Town's boom year is pretty much from 1820 to 1870. Unfortunately, in 1872, there was a dramatic fire that wiped out a lot of the Old Town, and it wasn't really rebuilt because the center of San Diego had shifted from the Old Town here down to Alonzo Horton's New Town, where our downtown is today. Oh, lots of good restaurants here. Miguel's here, famous for their jalapeno cheese dip. Another award winner, Cafe Coyote. You'll see how popular they are. They have historic sites. One of my favorites is the Whaley House. This was San Diego's courthouse, San Diego's first playhouse. It was a general store, and it's one of California's two certified haunted houses. Seven ghosts believed to be in residence. Where's our ghost down the page? Here we go. Seven ghosts there at the Wheelie House.
Yeah, I'm over us, girl.
Had a beautiful celebration here this week. They decorated the whole cemetery there for the El Dia de los Muertos, the Mexican Day of the Dead. Victorian houses were moved here to be preserved in the 1970s. And then this is a great museum, the Mormon Battalion Memorial, commemorates the longest infantry march from the bluffs of Iowa to Kansas all the way out to San Diego. No surprise, they were 2 months too late to help us with that Mexican-American war, but they did bring that fantastic brick kiln technology with them. Ladies and gentlemen, making our way into Old Town. Ladies and gentlemen, our trolleys leave here at the top and the bottom of the hour. The next tour leaving will be departing at 1:30. In the meantime, if you're looking for coffee, they got a little coffee cart. If you're looking for restrooms, third floor of that building, the elevator will take you up to the third floor. It's just to the left of Miss Kate there. And then there's also a ticket agent behind me and up ahead of us. That's trolley leaving 1:30, the first trolley at the end of the line. My name's Larry, and I wish you a beautiful day out there today. Thank you for joining us, and welcome to Old Town. Please watch your step. What's that? The first
first trolley goes down to the waterfront. That's the next stop, San Diego Harbor. Yeah, they call me Larry the Loop. We keep driving in circles. Have a great day. Oh, Costa de Guadalajara, Cafe Peony. They all have those margaritas for you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day, ladies. Have a great day. Thank you for joining us. What's that? Oh, dude, that's on your ticket. If you need to turn in your tickets, you do that here. Craig will help you do that. Have a great day, guys. Thanks for joining us. Great to see you today. Have a good day, guys. Have a beautiful day out there. Thank you so much. Thank you. Have a good day. Great day now. Watch your step. Thank you so much. Hello, sir. Do you want to continue on?
At our facility about a block away from here. Really, really nice. It is a very slow and much more personal look at the bay. You cruise along by the Navy Dolphin Training Facility. Our bays are patrolled, particularly by our warships, by naval swimming MPs or dolphins that are trained to protect our ships. And then you'll go out to the submarine base, and you'll go right alongside the live bait dock where the fishing ships go out and pick up their bait, but it's more regarded as a sea lion reserve. There's about 100 sea lions that live out there. And we kind of go right alongside. They'll swim up to the boat. Dolphins will go up to the boat. They'll go, you got some food? And we always say we don't have any food, and they swim away. So we get right alongside the sea lions. And it's really a wonderful way to hop on the water. And since you're on the trolley, typically the seal tickets are $34, but if you combine the trolley, go down there, they'll give you a ticket for $20. And any time in the future, you can come back here next year and say, I rode on the trolley with John back in November, and I want to do my seal today. And they go, okay, $20. It's, so we combine those and discount that. It's a wonderful, wonderful way to hop on the water. And much slower. They cruise out of the water about 5-6 knots rather than 12 knots like the normal cruises. On a day like today, it'd be great to get on the water. Day like yesterday, no. Actually, we pulled the seals out of the water yesterday when it started raining. We're going to make our way downtown and head out to Pacific Coast Highway and take a turn right down the old 101 and jump alongside parallel with the airport. Well, we're glad you're in San Diego, and welcome, and hope you're enjoying your stay here. The weather turned out to be perfect. We saw this on the radar charts last night, that it was going to be clear at 68 today. Tomorrow, it's going to be about 66, and right around the third or fourth quarter of the football game, the rain's going to come back. So, the Packers are annihilating the Chargers, and it starts spreading. Make your way away from the traffic, but it's fun. It's going to be a big, big crowd out there. Old Town, where we just departed from, a state historic park, as you can see on the sign here, was built in 1968 as a state historic park. Old Town is actually on the footprint of the oldest Spanish settlement on the West Coast. The first permanent European village on the West, sort of Jamestown or Williamsburg of the West, and it's where Spain settled. But built the fort and built the first of many missions, 21 missions now dot the landscape of California. And one reason it was built right here, for the simplest reason actually, is the source of water that Spain needed for its agriculture and sustenance just behind these brown buildings is the actual San Diego River. And the river runs from the mountains where it snows last night. One fork went out to the west of the ocean, one fork went to the south to the bay, and it ran into the bay, but that was all dammed off, and this became a flat, dry area called Dutch Flats, and then Spain built the roadway that drifts up about 680 miles, we call El Camino Real. You know that road? It's called Royal Road, the King's Highway, and it was the road of transportation that connections to the missions that stretch from San Diego to Oceanside, San Juan Capistrano, Los Angeles, Santa Maria, all the way north to San Francisco. These missions are all built in the 1770s, 1780s. Mars, probably the first. If you look back up on the hillside, our stars and stripes flying way up on top. That's where the first fort was up there. The fort was built as Presidio San Diego, a place they could. Invited or uninvited, there would be perhaps sailing in or coming in by horseback. Again, let me know when we get down by the waterfront, the comfort level of the back, because it is breezy, and we can secure one of those windows while we stay open. Along the way, we're going to share with you some of the sights, some of the sounds, some sound bites, a little bit of history, and some of the things you can enjoy while you're in San Diego. So we give you a little bit of info, team.